The International Association of Drilling Contractors has been remarkably consistent and persistent in pursuing its multiple missions of enhancing HSE in training, advancing drilling and completion technology, and championing sensible regulation and legislation that allow for the efficient and safe drilling of wells to supply the world with energy. Over that 70-plus years of our history, however, IADC has only been led by four chief executives until now. As of 29 February, Stephen Colville joined IADC as its president and chief executive officer, and we have the pleasure to be here with Stephen today to ask him a few questions about his background, his thoughts on the industry, and the path forward for IADC. So, Stephen, can you tell me a little bit about yourself, please?
Yes, Mike. Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. I started out my working career now back in the very early 80s, and I started as working in the civil servant for the UK government, as a policy civil servant, trying to turn political aspiration into regulation. I like to point out sensible regulation that benefited the industry and the economy rather than being obstructive. I spent about a decade doing that. I moved on to be a lobbyist working in continental Europe and the UK, assisting companies in antitrust activities, representing building and representing their case for them. I then moved on, joining the energy industry, working first for Chevron, did that around the world, working on policy, government, public affairs, and then having moved on from there, the last 5 years I've spent with Shell, based again out of Holland, but traveling the world continuously, doing corporate affairs. So that was work for all kinds of external stakeholders, the public, media, governments, and so on.
Steve, clearly you have a broad-based background that's going to benefit our members and the industry and the public very well. What do you see as some of the key challenges facing the drilling industry?
I think preeminent amongst those, Mike, is the paradox in which we're facing, where the world has never needed energy more than it does today. And that needs energy from all sources around the world. And at the same time, the ability of some of our members to produce, to find and drill and to produce those is being inhibited. It's being inhibited because there is often cases of overly burdensome regulation. Now, we all understand the need for correct and proper environmental and safety protection. We want that with regulation or not. Our members would seek to do those things and operate responsibly. But what we're actually now facing is many of the audiences who actually have the power to build the regulations or actually impact the political agenda are working from a base of very low understanding about what our members do, their activities, and actually how they are impacting the environment. And so that's what I'm saying. The key paradox is we have a level of ignorance out there at a time when there needs to be great understanding.
That's a pretty insightful analysis of the situation for our industry these days, in my opinion, Steve. And given that background of challenges in the outside world, what do you see, given again that you had this position less than 24 hours now, what do you see as some of the initiatives you would care to bring to IADC to move us forward to the next level?
Well, clearly I have to get my own understanding really right up to speed. So what we're going to focus on in the first 90 days is conducting a strategic review. That's going to be where we will be consulting the membership and thinking about where is this industry going to be in 5 years' time? Where should the IADC be? What should it be doing in 5 years' time? What would we look like? So if that's the point B on our journey, where do we get from A to B? What does that journey look like? And out of that, supporting that five-year strategic plan will be a three-year tactical rolling plan. And that is where we will be seeking to map specific activities that we can deliver. Underpinning that, of course, is my concern to ensure that we develop what I call a really impactful membership value proposition, where we actually have an understanding of what actually delivers the most value to them in their day-to-day activities. On that basis, we have some activities we know we want to kick off, even ahead of the review. Such things, I'll give you some examples. The drilling manual, for example, that was last updated about 7-8 years ago. It's in paper form, and as with paper, as soon as you print it, it's out of date. We obviously want to update that immediately. We're going to do it on an online form, And we have an idea of trying to have a Wikipedia aspect to that, where the members who, where the greatest expertise lies, could actually be helping update that on a continual basis. So that will have a big impact on the members and bring value to them. The second thing which we're really concerned with is that members keep talking about it's people, people. You know, there's a huge growing demand for new people to come into our industry. We have an aging population of workers, and they're going to be needed to be replaced. To that end, we're looking to help them increase in their training and their development. And a major initiative for us is what we call the updating of the KSAs, which is the knowledge, skills and abilities. And under that, we're actually looking for the key jobs and activities around drilling so we can produce all of the training manuals that can help support that.
Those are exciting ideas, Steve, and it's fascinating to sit here and hear you talk about them. I think I'm safe in saying on behalf of IDC staff that we look forward to working through with these ideas and initiatives and taking IDC to the next level. Because folks, change is the only constant. And we've had a terrific run for the last 70 years. We've been persistent in pursuing our goals and objectives at IDC and flexible in adjusting those ideas to fit the needs of our member, the industry, and all stakeholders. We look forward to moving ahead, and you'll hear more about it on drillingcontractor.org. So thanks again for tuning into this webcast. I'm Mike Killalea. Keep drilling safe and keep it turning to the right. See you next time.